I'm going to be sharing with you three things that are blocking money from coming into your life in a much easier way, because making money is not that difficult. It's pretty easy to make money, but we're conditioned in a society to believe that money is actually this hard thing to make. There's this heaviness associated with money, how money's so difficult to make, and that it's so hard to make money. When in reality, if you understand the energy of money and how it actually works, and the energy dynamics of money and how you have to be, because most people are just focused on how do I take the right actions to make money. But they're missing the key component of money, which is the energy of money and how you are being in the world. Because the way you are being and your level of presence and consciousness and the way that you carry yourself and the identity that you have, who you think you are and your beliefs around money will actually make or break how much money you make in your life. So make sure that you stick until the third point, because the third point will literally dictate how much money you make in your life. If you don't understand this third point I'm going to share with you, you will not make as much money as you could in your life. So if you're new to this channel, I want you to hit that subscribe button and that notification bell, because I post a new video every single day. Also, if you want to work with me one-on-one and become a private client, then consider applying for a free consultation by hitting the website that's in the description box of this video. So the first thing that's blocking money from coming into your life is neediness and lack. Right? There's this neediness for money. Like, I need money. Because if you're in a sales call or something, or let's just say you want to get a job or you want to get a relationship, neediness repels things from coming into your life. And that really comes from the ego. We'll get to that later. But when you're needy for something, it implies that you don't have it. And there's a lack-based energy. It's not an abundant vibration. It's like you need this thing to fulfill you. And if you don't have it, then you feel like you're lacking something. Right? You feel like you're lacking something. If I don't get this thing outside of me, then I feel lack and I feel neediness and I need this to complete me. Right? There's an issue with that, because that kind of energy is signaling to the universe that you don't actually have what it is that you want within you already, and reality is just a reflection. You're just getting a reflection of your internal beliefs. So what you have to see is that neediness will repel money from your life. You're literally blocking it from your life because it's this lack energy. Like, if you're lacking something, you only get more of that in your life, because whatever you put your focus on, you actually get more of in life. And so if you feel like there's lack and there's this lack consciousness, there's this lack-based mentality where you feel like you don't have enough, where is that actually coming from? Where is this lack-based consciousness coming from? We'll get to that later, which connects to the third point, but there's a neediness and there's a deep-rooted fear that you don't have enough, right? You're not enough now. I'm not already enough. I need this money to complete me. And I think that if I get this money, then I'll feel better, which actually repels the money from coming to you. Whereas if you learned how to feel better now, understand that you were already whole and complete, then what happens? You end up getting more money in your life anyway, because now you're coming from a wholeness perspective. So don't be needy. Understand that the vibration of money is already within you, which is just a high vibration state being connected to the present moment. Like, richness is not about how much money you have. Feeling rich is being connected to the present moment. I'm pretty sure Bob Marley said one time in a video, he didn't have any money in his bank account, but he still felt rich, right? Eckhart Tolle said the same thing. Eckhart Tolle sat on a park bench for 5 to 10 years with no money in his bank account, and he said he still felt rich. Now I'm pretty sure he's worth like 70 million or some crazy number like that. And he doesn't actually care if he has money. Now he has all the money in the world and he's actually giving people value and he's getting money in return because he's in alignment with the energy of money. Right? Being aligned with the energy of money is not taking or needing something. It's giving value and then receiving back, because when you give, you receive. And that's the abundant frequency, non-ego state. And the ego wants to take. When you raise your vibration, you expand your consciousness, you feel the need to give and give more value. And then as a result, you get money back. Which leads me to my second point, which is the taking perspective, right? You feel like you have to take money from people and you're getting something from somebody. You're taking money from somebody. That's such a lack-based mindset. the mindset you want to start developing when it comes to getting more money or pretty much anything in life. You want to get a relationship, you want to make more money, whatever you want to do, you want to give people value. Give people more and you will get back more, because giving is a non-needy state, because giving implies that your cup is already full. It's like you're not walking around asking people to fill your cup. It's like, can you please fill my cup, sir? Fill my cup, please. Can you please fill my cup, sir? No, oh, I can't fill my cup. Can you actually fill my cup? Like, you're walking around asking people to fill your cup when what you have to do is fill your own cup and then help people to fill theirs, right? Help people fill their cup. Why are you asking people to fill your cup if your cup is already full, but you've convinced yourself that it's not full because of your ego, right? Stop taking money. You're not taking anything from people. You're giving people value and then getting something in exchange. That's what service is. My perspective on the word service has completely changed in the last like 6 months alone. Like, service is such an interesting concept. It's you're serving, you're being selfless. You're not being selfish when you serve somebody. You're giving somebody a service. And then so you get money back because you're being of service to somebody, right? It's just an exchange. It's an honest exchange. You don't want to have an imbalanced exchange in life. You want to be completely aligned with the energy of money. Being aligned with the energy of money means that you're giving and you're receiving back because you're giving. That's what the energy of money really is. It's about giving and then receiving. And the giving is the receiving, because there's no separation in life. We'll get to that later. So the third thing I have for you is a lower vibrational state of consciousness and ego. Because where is this neediness and this taking coming from, right? Where's this neediness come? Like, where does this lack-based mindset come from? I'm going to share with you a powerful truth that you maybe have never heard before, where the neediness and the lack is coming from your identity and who you think you are. The identity that you've built up for the last 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years believes that there's lack in the world, when there's no lack. There's no lack. It's the identity that you've built up believing that there's lack. You've attached to this construct of who you think you are, believing that there's not enough in the world and that it's hard to make money. What all that really is an unawareness of who you really are, which is somebody that gives people value. Right? You give people value when you're in a higher state of consciousness. And so when you're in the ego state, when you're at a low vibration, that's completely blocking money from coming into your life, because a low vibration implies that you are not enjoying the moment. Like, you need something outside of this moment. You need something that is not in this moment now, which makes no sense, because the present moment is the only moment that exists. But you need some other moment. And it's like, oh, I don't like this moment. I need to be in some other moment than this moment now, says the ego. They're always angry, always anxious, always worried. Oh, I always need more. I always feel lack. I'm so reactive. I don't have enough, Francis. I need more. How do I make more money? How do I attract my dream job, Francis? I just need a job. I want a job so badly, Francis. How do I get this job? Because you're at a low vibration. And so I know it may be difficult if you're going through some life situation. You need that job and you need that money. But what I'm sharing with you is just focus on the vibration first. Focus on raising your vibration first. Get to a higher state of being. Because at a lower state of being, you're never going to be able to attract money. Because at a lower state of consciousness, that implies lack and neediness. Being at a low state implies that you need something, because when you're at a high state, you don't need anything from anybody. You're at a high state because you're happy where you are. A low state of consciousness and attachment to the ego and the thoughts implies a neediness for money. It implies I want to take money and take something from somebody, because ego is synonymous for selfishness, right? So stop being selfish. Get to a higher state of vibration and then actually attract money into your life in a much easier way. Because when you're at a high vibration, you will naturally get into alignment with the career. Like, I'm making this tangible for you. It's not just you get to a high vibration and then you attract money in 24 hours. Like, I've personally never been able to attract money in 24 hours. Like, I think I have, because I use affirmations all the time and I get money consistently. But it's about the core vibration that I'm on. So I get money within 24 hours when I focus on it, because I'm already at that high vibration. Like, so 24-hour manifestations work, and they work for me sometimes, like, generally speaking, but it's not the 24-hour manifestation technique that really gave that to me. It's the high vibration that it put me on, which then made it easy to attract what it is that I want. So understand that attracting money is about the energy that you're on. It's about putting yourself into a state where it's actually easy to get money because your cup is so full that you're giving so much that you actually receive money. And the way that you do this is by getting to a high vibration state where you naturally want to give more people value, you want to give more people things. If you're at a low vibration state, you're at a selfish state. You're not interested in giving people value and helping people. You just want to help yourself. But then the paradox is that when you raise your vibration, you start to help people, you end up helping yourself anyway because there is no separation between you and the other. I know it sounds paradoxical, but what you'll see at the end of the day is that everything is connected. There are no coincidences, and that you are actually connected with everybody. So what happens is when you raise your vibration, you give more value, that energy comes back to you either right in that moment or at some point in the future. That's how money works. So essentially, aligning yourself with the energy of money means to just align yourself with who you really are, right? If you align yourself with who you really are and your core vibration, which is just pure consciousness and awareness, you end up making more money. It ends up coming into your life in a much easier way. So if you stop focusing on how do I get something outside of myself, but you focus on raising your vibration first, you'll actually get more money and it'll remove the first two points anyway. The neediness and the lack and the taking mentality will be removed as a result of raising your vibration, and you'll naturally find a career that you enjoy. Something will pop up into your life where you're like, oh, that's a good career. Actually, that'll help people give, I can help people in this way. Like, you'll be like, you'll feel inspired. You'll be like, oh, that can actually help people more than I thought. But you have that thought because you get higher quality thoughts when you're at a higher state of consciousness. And then those higher quality thoughts will lead you to higher quality actions that will lead you to more money because those actions are coming from a high consciousness state where you actually are taking action that gives people value, right? It's the kind of action that you take, not what actions you take. You can take all the action in the world to try to make more money, but if your identity believes that there's lack and that you're in a lack-based consciousness, you're never going to be able to make money in your life. It's never going to come into your life. I always had so many issues making money. I used to go to school doing something that I hated, and now I make money consistently doing what I love because it's easier to make money when you're in a high vibration state, and I had to learn this. I realized that there's a deep connection between your consciousness and how much money you make, right? The higher level, this is tangible stuff. I'm not just saying raise your vibration, attract money 24 hours. I'm talking like a lifelong path where if you dedicate yourself to raising your consciousness, you'll eventually have to make more money because you're not aligned with the lower vibrational states of ego. The ego blocks money. So when you raise your consciousness and you raise your awareness, it actually becomes much easier to make money because you intuitively want to help people more, and then the energy comes back to you in the form of money, whether on accident or you specifically understanding that's how it works. The best businesses work when they follow their hearts and give people value. A business that is based on ego and just taking will eventually collapse. The best businesses in the world that are still alive to this day give people value to some degree. If the business is just focused on taking and getting money, the business will never be successful. So really what I'm communicating to you right now is a powerful truth that the best businesses are higher consciousness businesses, and because a higher consciousness implies giving people value. So are you seeing the connection between consciousness and business? Are you seeing this? Because consciousness and a higher consciousness state is exactly what a business is. What is a business? A business is giving people value, getting something in return. When you don't have an ego and you're in a high consciousness state, what do you naturally do? You give people value and you help people because you're at a selfless state. When you're selfless, you give. When you're selfish, you take. When you're selfless, you give. When you're selfish, you take. When you have an ego, you are selfish. When you don't have an ego and you're in a high consciousness state, you are selfless. Equals higher consciousness state equals money. That's the formula. I just gave you the perfect formula for money. Write this down in your notes right now. Higher consciousness equals money. Write that down. Maybe it won't happen in the first day, maybe not in the first 2 days, but if you align yourself with this understanding and you align your career with this, you align your business with this mentality, you align your social interactions with this mentality, you'll make more money. It has to happen. That's the law of the universe, is that you give and you receive, because that's karma. It's the law of the universe. And so if you take, you're sacrificing, you're losing something. That part, it's a lose-lose, right? The ego is this lose-lose mentality. Start giving more. Follow your passion, give people value into a higher consciousness state, and you will actually make more money in your life. So I wanted to announce that I have a free guided meditation that's specifically designed to help you connect deeper to the present moment and totally surrender yourself to the moment as it is, that will raise your vibration, help you to attract more money. So if you want to try that out, it's totally free. Just hit the link that's in the description box of this video. Have yourself a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.